8.2 Personal Resilience. That which does not kill us makes us stronger. Friedrich Nietzsche. Do levels of individual physical fitness matter in respect of contributing directly to an organization's overall resilience? President John F. Kennedy thought so. Our growing softness, our increasing lack of physical fitness, is a menace to our security, he said of American society in the early 1960s as he launched a National Council of Fitness. Fast forward 4 decades from Kennedy's Camelot presidency, and we see that 4 small groups of people could seize control of 4 civilian passenger jets and direct them into crowded buildings, armed with just bolt cutters and knives. A few weeks later in 2001, other cabin crew staff and passengers were luckier. They physically suppressed and stopped terrorist Richard Reed from detonating an onboard bomb. Reed had explosives tucked in a shoe heel and was travelling upon a crowded Boeing jet running from Paris to Miami. Tragically, almost 100 commercial airliners have been attacked by bombs, a third by identifiable terrorist groups, with the loss of some 3,000 passengers since 1933, reports Aerospace Web. In reality, then, individual physical fitness and resilience can only take us so far along a path of delivering a resilient culture or organization. In fact, it is fair to say that the root causes of insecurity during modern times have little connection to personal fitness and resilience. The industrialization of weapons technology and the continued proliferation of weapons of mass destruction continues to threaten humanity, or vast portions of it. For each year between 2004 and 2011, the world spent $60 to $80 billion each year on buying arms and defense products, stated the website of Global Issues in 2014. Moreover, investment by public authorities and private companies in cybersecurity management has burgeoned. Companies have had servers and cloud accounts hacked, bank accounts plundered, and research and development blueprints stolen and counterfeited. Customers have had their ATM cards cloned, tax records destroyed and compromised, PIN numbers and passwords scanned and stolen. Governments and their military systems have been comprehensively breached by outsiders and insiders, committing physical and information attacks upon their colleagues and countries. Why, then, should we be worried by individual fitness and personal resilience issues at all? How can physical fitness or personal resilience training help larger organizations become more resilient? Moreover, as Diana Kutu from the Harvard Business Review puts it, why do some people and some companies buckle under pressure? And what makes others bend and ultimately bounce back?